A newly discovered tetrapod bone means we've been on land longer than scientists thought. Don't you just love it when nature throws science a bone? Hey guys, Amy making bad jokes for you on D News today. But jokes aside, bones are pretty useful, and not just for giving us the internal stability to not be goopy piles of flesh and organs, but because they persist over the ages and give us vital clues as to the history of various species. It's from fossilized dinosaur bones that we've been able to reconstruct what the Earth might have looked like long before humans roamed. And going back further, it's from bones and fossils that we can trace how species have evolved. The fossil record tells us that life started in primitive oceans before the first species poked their heads out of the water and crawled onto land. These are so-called transitional species, and scientists have been able to determine that they first appeared when limbs evolved from fish fins about 360 million years ago, followed by the first land-based tetrapods that showed up around 330 million years ago. But there's a pretty big gap in there scientists needed to fill. To figure out what happened during this 30 million year gap, researchers from the Queensland Museum in Hendra, Australia, analyzed a rare tetrapod fossil from that time period, a nearly 5-foot-long Osynodus that lived about 333 million years ago. They found from preserved forearm bones that the species could support itself on land. Now, whether it did or did not is a different story, and that evidence came from what might be the oldest known broken bone. In studying this broken bone, the team used computer software to reconstruct the forces required to cause the break. It turns out that it was a lot of force, much larger than the animal itself. And because water acts as a cushion, there's no way such a bad break could have happened underwater. The transitional animal that left that broken bone must have been on land. From reconstructing the break, the team concluded that the animal likely fell from a rock or log about 3 feet off the ground. Of course, they can't be sure, but it's pretty probable given the bone-based evidence. So if the Osynodus broke a bone on land, it must have spent at least some time out of the water, and that makes it the oldest known tetrapod to be fairly well adapted to life on land, getting us one step closer to nailing down the moment when animals first left the water. Scientists are always learning more about how we evolved to be the complex creatures we are today, but is it possible for evolution to reverse itself? Julia discusses that idea in this episode.
Over the millennia, the genes that coded for the pisiform were still there, they were just dormant, and when they were expressed again, they were no longer good for walking around on all fours, but they were great for flying.
I know 333 million year old bones are literally old and dusty, but what do you guys think of this preserved injury? Let us know in the comments below, or let us know on Twitter at DNews, and I'm on there as well as AST Vintage Space. And of course, for more DNews every single day of the week, don't forget to subscribe.